Junya Ishigami's Windy House suggests that the building is constructed with a large ring-shaped space of varying height. Warm air rises and cold air falls, causing a pleasant breeze to circulate inside at all times. Our project will therefore aim to create a pleasant breeze both day and night, multidirectionally.
With that in mind, we have researched and stumbled upon nature's own ventilation system, the leafcutter's ant nest. During the day, the sun hits the outer chambers more rapidly than the core, moving air up the outside and down in the middle. During the night, this current reverses. The outer chambers lose heat to the cool night air. Air exchange occurs through tiny holes on the outer walls. This is due to the Kuenda effect. When the breeze flows over a hill, the air is deflected over the top. This pulls air along, drawing air out of the ant hill. The ants build lower entrances nearby, where air is drawn in to replace it, ventilating the whole colony with a breeze. A report informs us that the ratio is fixed at 4 outflow vents to 1 inflow vent. The presence of wind accelerates airflow by 3 to 10 folds due to venturi effect. In this experiment, we have yet to determine which were the outflow and inflow vents, but managed to observe that smoke accelerates in the area of lower pressure. This batch of experiments were an exploration of ideal gradients and to confirm the report's claim of the 4 outflows to 1 inflow ratio. We experimented with various angles on each side of the mound and settled with the 60 degree by 45 degree model as it gave the best result. From these experiments, we discovered that the openings can be positioned anywhere, provided at least one outflow opening stems from the lower pressure zone. This batch of experiments were an investigation of the ideal volume of spaces to accelerate wind on top of the information given by the existing report. We discovered that the model with the longest tube and smallest volume produces the fastest wind speed result. This observation will be used in the later stages of our final design. With the experimental results collected, we are now drafting iterations of our final design. With reference to our earlier mound experiments, we understand that each mound is a single unit that works independently to accelerate wind. By combining many units together, we postulate that it would create a multidirectional, windy space. With wind directions differing at different times of the day, this multidirectional design allows us to achieve the acceleration of wind at all times.
These iterations were drafted based on the rotational concept. As the mound was designed on plan, we decided to spiral them up, forming a tower. All the models had openings in multiple directions, covering 360 degrees. Iteration 8 was not only designed to catch wind from multiple directions, but also incorporated a long internal tube that accelerates wind through the venturi effect, while maintaining a small volumetric space within. This corresponds with our previous findings, which explains the reason for it achieving the highest wind speed in comparison to the other models. Thereafter, we explored different materials to find out which is the most suitable for a 1-to-1 model at 1.5 meters height. On the top, we stacked 2 millimeters of corrugated cardboard. At the bottom, we covered the cardboard with paper mache as a lighter alternative for clay. Ultimately, we decided to stick with corrugated cardboard as it had a more aesthetic finish. In iteration 9, we wanted to design an interior space that would also allow this system to work, such that the tower would be ventilated inside out. This would be explained in greater detail later in the video. With the original volume within the tower, we designed tubes that connect two rooms to the central chimney. These rooms have openings facing one another for cross ventilation to occur, and are 4 times larger than the openings on the exterior walls. Therefore, to retain the original ratio of 4 outflow vents to 1 inflow vent, a special system was designed to allow only one window to be opened at a time. This also allows personalization according to the individual's preferences. As a pleasant breeze is subjective, these windows allow users of the space to adjust the wind speed, direction, and sunlight, depending on the time of the day, to suit their own preferences. This is the plan view of our final design, illustrating how the rooms are ventilated inside out. Wind would be drawn in from the exterior walls due to the Coanda effect, or area of low pressure, circulating within the central chimney of the tower. Within the central chimney, small amounts of the rooms are protruded out, creating more areas of low pressure in the air-filled chimney. The Coanda effect will once again draw air into each room, allowing them to be ventilated. With all these aspects combined, we have settled on our final design.